ferocious battle. But going back to what you mentioned, that's big news for me in terms of the Tipperary full back line. If there's one area that you were maybe worried about, and in an era outside of the Limerick full back line where top class inside defenders aren't prevalent, he's a huge loss to Tipperary today.
Absolutely.
Does it mean that they'll change their, or have changed their structure around it?
We were trying to speculate during the break there, myself and Henry, who'd actually pick up Gillane, because obviously Cahill was, you know, that was his job the last time. He was doing it really well up until the injury. I remember wondering would Ronan Maher actually go back and pick him up?
And they know each other. They know each other from college.
They come across each other directly too often, but I'm sure there was the odd collision here and there, but I think...
Sorry, Graham Mulcahy and Peter Casey aren't exactly so...
Sure, they all take watching. What you probably have is the best six forwards in the country in one way, Joanne and Tipp, up against the best six backs in the country in Limerick. I think it's going to be ferocious, Joanne. I actually still hold the belief that Limerick did not want to be here. But I'll finish with it now, right? But now that... As soon as that, John Kiley and Paul Kinnerk, etc., Alan Cunningham and Brian Geary, as soon as that result came through from Innes, they'd have been 100% saying, now we have to win the Munster final. We're in it now. We may not want to have been, but once we're there, Tipperary are coming to the Gaelic grounds, we've to be ferocious. On the other hand, you're going to have Liam Sheedy saying, oh, this crowd could come down and think they could beat us by dropping four of their best. And now we've to go up and they just reintroduce them. I'd say that Tipperary dressing room during the week was absolutely red hot. Listen to Liam Sheedy, if I know Liam well enough, and I think the three of us know him fairly well, I think the exchanges here could be absolutely ferocious.
Because there have also been questions asked of Liam Sheedy, well, was he wrong then to go with his full team the last day?
No, I think the momentum they're building, they had to continue that. And Limerick are All-Ireland champions, they're up there to be brought down, and they need to set down a marker to say, we are the top dogs now. So I think Liam had to go for it. Obviously, he was very unfortunate to pick up, you know, the serious injury to Bonner, who we haven't discussed, a massive loss for him over the course of the year. But I think Barrett's a major loss today for what they're facing in Galan. So, but I agree with you, certainly. They should have brought you into the dressing room this week instead of getting goal, because you were psyched up there myself.
Yeah, but in their minds down there, and anyone that's at the game now, the All-Ireland series doesn't. This is the Munster championship. Yeah. Like, this is a bad.
The rest of your life doesn't count.
That's exactly. Yeah. Monday morning might never come at all, right? is the way that you.
Just 70 minutes ahead of me here.
Exactly. And isn't that beauty? And don't we all miss that feeling, right?
Yeah.
I certainly miss it anyway. But the today. That badge of honour, that Munster medal, that's all that matters down here. And there's a huge rivalry between Tipp and Limerick.
Yes.
My sister's married down in Limerick. I was never really aware of it until I got a bit more knowledge and insight. There's a huge down around Oola there.
Gary Spillane, Doom, Newport, around there.
Okay. Massive rivalry.
Who's going to come away with the medal?
I think Tipp. I'll go with Tipp.
Anthony?
I go with Limerick because I think they have to.
And don't allow.
I've been saying Tipp all week. Barrett's a huge loss in addition to the Bonner, but I just think that they've that bit more hurling than Limerick have got.
Brilliant scenes. It looks an absolutely beautiful, albeit windy day down in Limerick. So let's head over now for a commentary. Michael Dagnan and Ger.
Thank you very much indeed, Joanne. Yes, you're quite right. It is windy, and that wind is blowing from left to right, down from the Clare end, as it were, down towards the dressing room, which was occupied by Tipperary before this match. But what an occasion. It's Portmanwell, otherwise the LIT Gaelic grounds, the colourful setting for the Munster final for the sixth time in the last 30 years. And was mentioned there is such a rivalry between Limerick and Tipperary. I think Anthony Daly was just saying there in the build-up to that, Michael, from Limerick's point of view, the All-Ireland champions simply have to win it.
Yeah, well, look, it's a Munster final. I think what happened before now doesn't really come into it. There's 46,000 people. The atmosphere down here in the Gaelic grounds was just unbelievable from 2 hours before the game. Great minor match beforehand. Limerick got a good win. And just on the Cottle Barrett thing, just watching him in the warm-up, he was 100% to me. He looked perfect. He did every bit of the warm-up out in the field. He was moving off left and right. I know a bit about hamstring injuries over the years, and he didn't look like a lad. So maybe it's just that he missed a couple of weeks training or whatever, and they decided not to start him. But he did everything. He's togged out. He's looking fit and fresh and sharp. So interesting maybe that they didn't take a chance on him. I think if it was a knockout game, they would have.
He's a named sub, which means he can come in. They weren't in a position to bring in a number 27 or a number 28. That's the new ruling that's been in place for a while now. And the question then is posed, of course, who's going to be picking up Aaron Gillan? Will it be one of the two wing halves, Brendan Maher or Ronan Maher?
Yeah, look, that half-factor has been so effective. I think he's going to be slow to make a change there. Seamus Kennedy must have been impressing the trainer, but he's obviously known as a right half-back. So will it be Ronan or Brendan Maher, or will he chance Kennedy on him? I'm not sure. We'll find out in a couple of minutes. But it's just that half-back has been so influential. But Gillan is such a key man. He's going to have to be watched. But, you know, Graham McCaughey, also a big man for the big occasion. And Peter Casey, supposedly the best forward. The reason that Seamus Flanagan is not playing on this team is because every night in training, Casey is the best Limerick forward.
It's unusual as well, this particular 2019 final, which has been attended by the President of Ireland. And a very welcome guest he is, of course, to enjoy this afternoon's final. But the unusual aspect for me, in a way, is because they just met 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, they did. It's this round robin, you know, it is thrown up all sorts of permutations, all sorts of matches. But as I said a few minutes ago, you know, this is a Munster final. A lot of these Limerick players, only a couple of them have won Munster medals. So it's a massive, massive match.
Before the action, the national anthem, played by the Tulloch Cuaraclare St. Patrick's Pipe Band. Positions from Tulla in County Clare, but the players from Limerick and for Tipperary. The 71st ever championship meeting of these counties, the 69th in Munster, and what a setting that is. There were fans coming in and around the Gaelic grounds from about 9 o'clock this morning.
Yeah, Ger, Brendan Maher gone straight back to full back. Gillan is in at full forward. James Barry switch out to the corner onto Casey.
And it is Tipperary trying to get this early possession here. Dan McCormack involved out here as far as Jason Ford, and Ford slings it in and puts this one over the bar right from the very... Has he? No, he hasn't. Wide ball. It's a first miss of the match instead. I was nearly ready to write it down.
Yeah, well, such a feature of Tipperary's play so far, the forward play, all the forwards scoring freely from play forward, man of the match in a match already in Munster, and he'd be disappointed with that. Bit of nerves there just at the start of the game.
Nicky Quay then pucking it out for Limerick, looking towards Kyle Hayes, the big tall man at number 11, but it's collected once again here by a Tipperary man in Ronan Maher this time, and the referee, who is Paul O'Dwyer from Carlow, in charge, giving the free to Tipp.
Now, what a catch. You know, we saw Ronan Maher in 16 at centre-half back, but you see Paddy under that ball as well, determined that Kyle Hayes wasn't going to catch the first ball, and a brilliant catch by Ronan Maher.
This free to be taken by Noel McGrath, playing in his 49th ever championship match. Inside his own 65-metre line as he strikes it. Wind behind him. And this time the umpire does go for the white flag. And it's the opening point of the Munster final.
Yeah, great options on the frees for Tipperary. You know, Jason Ford taking over from Callanan this year, and then McGrath to take the long ones as well.
Great options. Into the hands here of Garrod Hegarty. Loses it immediately, however. Noel McGrath trying to win it. Hand pass forward there. That was by Seamus Kennedy. Picked up in the middle of the park by Kian Lynch. Slinging it forward here as far as Hegarty again. Second involvement in this match. And he fires it well. And it's the opening point from play in this Munster final. Scored by Garrod Hegarty. And the teams are level, a point apiece.
Yeah, just look, the pick up there from Kian Lynch was sensational. Flick up into his hand. And then through the hand pass, Hegarty kept the run going. And he was a huge loss the last day. You know, he's on his day one of the great forwards of the modern game.
Brian Hogan, goalkeeper for Tipperary. All the way down towards the opposing 20-metre line. picked up here by Mike Casey, trying to get that ball away, get out of trouble, helped out by his captain, Declan Hannan. Early hints of nerves, understandably so, from players on both teams. That's a very, very good hook there by Jake Morris, back helping. Hand passed away by Michael Breen, out as far as John O'Dwyer. And the man they call Bubbles fires it in with wonderful accuracy. Opening point of the game for him.
Yeah, look, one of the key matchups, Declan Hannan there, you can see him getting caught in possession. He's marking Bubbles O'Dwyer. He drifted away to the far side, ball came to him over the bar.
From the next puck out, it was James Barry sliding in to try and get that one for Tipperary. Under pressure there with Peter Casey picking himself off the ground. Aaron Gillan there as well. Eventually it's Brendan Maher who gets it. Down on the ground here, over the ball, referee not terribly far away. Out it comes towards Aaron Gillan again. Barry there trying to close the space for him. Still managed to get it in a couple of metres in as far as Graham Mulcahy, a very experienced player. Plays it back. Garrod Hager to play it into the centre field player. Kian Lynch, stinging shot there. Brian Hogan managed to save it, and Hogan under a little bit of pressure there. Outside his square. A real pile-up of bodies eventually collected and eventually put away out of danger by Noel McGrath. Back down the field it goes. Limerick with an extra player back there defending. Richie English caught it in as far as Hannan. Gives it off here immediately towards Tom Morrissey. Hand pass back towards his brother Dan. And the 26-year-old goes forward here. His brother there, his younger brother, was in assistance still. Eventually it reaches Aaron Gillan, and Gillan tries to measure it with accuracy. Doesn't quite have it.
Joe, what a goal chance there for Limerick. Great run by Lynch, but he should have passed it. Kyle Hayes, if you watch here, Kyle Hayes completely free in his right-hand side. Good save by Hogan, very brave then down on the break. But if that ball was slipped to Kyle Hayes there, he was straight through on goal. And Tipperary glad to clear their lines there.
First real opportunity for them. Line ball on this near side of the field for Mike Casey to hit. Real bumper crowd here. They're saying it's in excess of 44,000. And people were making their way into the stadium. But from about 10:30, we've had showers as well. A very good minor match, as Michael Dagnan was mentioning, won by Limerick by 117 to 111 against Clare. Limerick trying to do the double. Declan Hannan out as far as Sean Finn. Wonderful season that he's had so far. It's 2-1, and it's Graham Mulcahy trying to get the better there of Sean O'Brien. Mulcahy, such a tricky operator. Toddy Marr goes down on the ground, looking for a little bit of assistance. There's Sean O'Brien to help out, and taking it away is O'Brien. And from Newport, collected in the middle of the park by Will O'Donoghue, the Napiershig player. Gets away from his man rather easily. That was Bubbles putting in a half-hearted challenge that time. Up as far as Kian Lynch. Lynch playing it back into space again towards his midfield ally. And Will O'Donoghue hits. And he's missed. Really good opportunity.
Yeah, only very poor wide. He had two chances there. Will, he went to pass the ball to Kian Lynch first off, and it wasn't on. And then the second one, you know, straight in front of the goal, he should have stuck that over the bar.
Tipperary go short. Down it comes as far as Ronan Marr. Picked up here by John O'Dwyer again. Then fired forward by Noel McGrath. He's already scored from a free, and this one is going left. A number of missed opportunities so far, Michael.
Yeah, a bit of nerves, and, you know, the strong wind. Tipperary have a strong breeze blowing with them. I'd say it's a 4 or 5 point wind at least.
Mike Casey has this one. Holds off would-be challengers. Inside here as far as the big man, Kyle Hayes. To his right-hand side, Will O'Donoghue, ready to take a return, is Hayes. Here he comes. They're chasing after him, they can't catch him. A beautiful score by Kyle Hayes, the 21-year-old from Kildymo.
Yeah, that's what Don Logan was talking about before, and tried to play the ball through him. That was played to his feet, he won it, and played a nice 1-2 with Will O'Donoghue, and the pace of him, when he gets on that run, we saw it so often last year, particularly the Ireland final against McInerney. Impossible to stop.
Straight from the pocket there, collected by Dan Morrissey, fed in as far as Kian Lynch, forward again by Declan Hannan this time, trying to win it as Peter Casey succeeds in that, gets away from James Barry, and there's another one for Limerick, and it's a point by Peter Casey this time, and Limerick are in front here by 3-2.
Yeah, and the influence of Hannan there, he was missing the last, that's what he does so well.
From the next puck out, it's John O'Dwyer trying to make some headway over there. running into a couple of Limerick players, out as far as Dan McCormack, the man who replaces Bonner Maher in this team. Down he went as he hit that one, and he's got it over the bar somehow. What an amazing point that is by Dan McCormack.
Well, sometimes he misses handy enough ones. He had no time there, just on the sideline, snapshot, and straight over the bar. That's a super score from McCormack. But you saw Garrett Hegarty chasing back there. You saw Hannan's influence so far. The lads were missing for Limerick the last time, making a huge difference so far today.
Nicky Quaid's puck out into the centre, collected by Tipperary again. It's by Noel McGrath out here to Ronan Maher. And Ronan fires it from 65 metres. Oh, it's a wonderful point. Well, there was nobody putting in the challenge on him. Found the target, found the range brilliantly.
The matchup so interesting. Ronan Maher on Hegarty. Hegarty going deep. He stayed back and got the pass in that instance where Hegarty had already got a score off him. The same with Tariq Maher and Kyle Hayes winning some ball as well. So tactically, very interesting so far.
Tip for the last two scores. Noel McGrath again, hand passing it in here. Taking it forward, Sean O'Brien losing his way then. Recycled once more by McGrath, back as far as Tariq Maher. Trying to change the direction of the attack somewhat. Coming out to try and get to this one and succeeding is Jake Morris. Morris, who won an All-Ireland under 21 here last year against Cork, has missed the opportunity to get another point.
Yeah, that's what Tariq Maher does so well. You know, he gets time on the ball there to look up and play a lovely ball into space. And again, with the wind behind him, Jake Morris will be disappointed to put that one wide.
It's the most wonderful setting here in Limerick. Thankfully, the rain has stayed off. We had a few showers, as I mentioned, earlier on in the day, but right now, nice and dry. Breeze behind Tipperary for the opening 35 minutes. That's Seamus Kennedy, who came in as a replacement for Carl Barrett before the start of the match. Hitting that one, but another missed opportunity. And another one has gone astray, and that's four wides now by Tipperary.
Yeah, great piece of control and skill and good solo run, but it was the wrong option. I should have played it inside in front of John McGrath, who had shown for it.
From the short puck out, it's Richie English. Nobody closing down the man coming out with it immediately. Will O'Donoghue showing a lot of authority. Eventually that ball runs away from one of the Limerick players in midfield, collected instead by Tariq Maher. Maher fouled, free in. Not exactly the helter-skelter start we're kind of expecting.
No, they're checking each other out, though. You know, I mentioned a couple of those one-on-one battles that are going to be so crucial to the game. Bubbles trying to drift away from Hannan, but Hannan getting on the ball. Bubbles already got a point. Hegarty and Ronan Maher, Kyle Hayes and Tariq Maher. So early stages, and they're, as I say, sussing each other out.
Jason Ford, one miss already right at the very beginning of the game for him. So second opportunity, and this one he's got spot on. Playing in his third Munster final. So two between them, Tipperary making the better start. Limerick having that goal chance earlier on, which was stopped by the goalkeeper. Ford again, back down into the inside forward line, down there towards Jake Morris. And where he goes, Sean Finn is going. Ends up being free for Limerick. Morris, one of these fine young players from that wonderful under-21 team last year, getting promotion. Dermot Burns taking the free. Dropped there by Peter Casey, trying to go again. Seamus Kennedy getting in to try and get possession. Helping out is Noel McGrath. Slinging it all the way back as far as his goalkeeper, Brian Hogan. Brian, whose dad, Ken, of course, was many times a Munster champion. Five Munster medals in all. Limerick come again. Will O'Donoghue easily picking out Kyle Hayes. Forward it comes. And eventually going down there was Garrod Hegarty. Losing possession, it's Ronan Maher once more. Now Tariq Maher. Slinging it across to the far side into open space, but there's nobody there in a Tipperary jersey, and measured poorly anyway. It's gone out over the sideline, as you can see.
Yeah, well, a big change in Limerick today from the last is the ferocity of their tackling up front. They're closing down the Tipperary backs a lot quicker. They're not giving them the time to look up and pick out the perfect pass. So far, that's three or four balls that have just been played away aimlessly by the Tipperary halfback line.
We've got a shot there of John Kiley, third year in charge, and he would love to win a Munster title as manager. 1-1 as a selector 6 years ago. Here's Declan Hannan. Lovely little ball that time from Hegarty. In as far as Hayes. They try to keep it going, however, and it breaks down there, and it's Dan McCormack who's back fouled inside his own 45-metre line. Committing the offence was Graham Mulcahy. Referee goes forward to have a little word with him.
Yeah, and that's going to be a yellow card. Interestingly, at the toss, Ger, I was just watching Pádraig O'Dwyer, and he indicated to both captains with his arm across his neck that he was going to be looking out for that head-high tackle, which is a yellow card, and if it's an aggressive one, it's a red card this year in the championship, so that's an early yellow.
So Mulcahy penalised. Limerick trailing. Tipperary with the next possession. It'll be another free for Noel McGrath.
And this will tell us a bit about the wind, you know, if he can get the distance from here. It'll be an indication.
Playing in his fifth Munster final. He's already scored today. That's 4 points in all he's got in Munster finals, and that's about as good as it gets for the moment. Another ball has gone astray there. Lack of accuracy, five wides. Nicky Craig, the 30-year-old from Effin, ready to tuck the ball out. Down through the centre, looking for Hayes. Batted down instead there by Seamus Kennedy. Coming onto it quickly is Cian Lynch, and Lynch hitting it confidently and hitting it well. Beautiful point by Cian Lynch.
We've seen some brilliant touches so far from Lynch, but the way he read that break there, he let the three lads go up, he picked up the break, and you see him driving forward and shortening the grip, and that's a great strike into the breeze.
So the gap is back to a point once again. Problems here for James Barry, the Tipperary fullback, being attended to there by Dr. Brendan Murphy, who himself was, of course, an absolutely brilliant player with Offaly. There's Liam Sheedy. Well, he's already led the Premier County to a couple of Munster titles in his time in the past, back in 2008 and 2009. For the record, this is his 19th championship match in two spells and 15 wins so far. The one they will all remember, of course, the 2010 All-Ireland final. That is a fantastic crowd. Thankfully, it's dry, because there's nothing as bad as sitting down there on damp seats for the afternoon, no matter how fanatical a Tipp and Limerick fan you may be.
And no ball in between Brendan Maher and Gillan yet, with all the build-up we had before the game.
And we haven't seen Seamus Calman in action just yet either. That's out by Hannon. It's picked up there by Jake Morris, but the referee has blown his whistle. And you can see Dermot Burns talking about a hand pass being legitimate. The referee didn't see it. He thought it was a throw. Let's have a look again here when that ball eventually left his hand. Well, we don't see it there. Free anyway, which is going to be to Tipperary. And once again, it'll be Jason Ford, a man who knows Limerick very, very well indeed. Went to UL and played Fitzgibbon, of course, with the likes of Mike Casey and Tom Morrissey and Garrod Hegarty. He was in that team as well. That's a second one for him. Both his points today coming from frees.
And I think that team was a huge part of Jason Ford's development. You know, he was struggling a little bit with Tipperary, but winning with those players, that great team, I think brought him on an awful lot.
You have lots and lots of combinations of connections like that right throughout this match this afternoon. Sean Finn and John McGrath, also old pals. Opposing teams today, however. Here comes Sean Finn now, bang on cue. About to be challenged by Jake Morris. Still managed to get that ball down, intended for Alan Gillan. As you mentioned, Michael, he really hasn't touched the ball so far, and we are now playing some 16 minutes of this game.
Yeah, Jake, I think Jake Morris's athleticism is a big part. You know, that Tipperary forward line have a lot of mileage, but he is covering a lot of ground, closing down players, getting in that little half-hooker tackle and getting into an eye line, and that was instrumental there again.
That ball has gone astray. There are a lot of Limerick players there to try and pick it up. And between them, they should be able to manage to do so. Made a bit of a dog's dinner of it, but finally it's Dan Morrissey getting it forward to Tom, his brother. Little block on it. And coming across here to try and get possession, Dan McCormack already using up a lot of energy, covering a lot of ground, getting it in as far as John O'Dwyer. And what will O'Dwyer do with this one? Well, he's turned it away to the left-hand side and missed the opportunity. Just 1 point so far for Bubbles, six whites for his team. From this puck out, it's Dan Morrissey for Limerick. And again, once again, looking to try and feed the inside forward line, but it's James Barry instead for Tipp. Forward as far as Ronan Maher, already a point scorer, runs into a hefty collision, which the referee decides to penalise. Let's watch again. There was a drag back there, just a little one, not an awful lot involved, but when they came in.
Yeah, it was just that little tug on the shorts and said something then to the ref. Moves it forward.
very short in as far as Seamus Caldon. First time he's been seen in the action. He's got a goal a game in the last four matches. He's got another one. Five goals in five games in this year's championship, and it's goal number 32 for the career of a wonderful player.
Yeah, Gerard, it was a quick free, but look at the Limerick defenders backing off. Someone like Seamus Caldon, you have to go to him. You have to, as Sean Finn, and he just backed off and backed off. He had only one thing in his mind, goal, and a brilliant goal it was, but poor defending there by Limerick.
Well, he could hardly believe the amount of space and time he was given that opportunity to get another goal, Seamus Caldon. Now it's Garrod Hegarty, and Limerick need to buck up. But that was a very good challenge there. It came in from Dan McCormack on Garrod Hegarty. Didn't make life easy for him, but this is the goal again.
Yeah, look at the jink around, brilliant. But look, he couldn't believe it. Nobody came to him, went through, but great composure, great finish, but he got far, far too much time with the ball.
Well, Limerick have players back. Here's one of them. That is Dermot Burns. Now an opportunity to pick out Cian Lynch. He's got space. Well, he had. Now he gets past Paddy Maher. Ronan Maher's trying to hook him, and between them they got that ball away, helped out by James Barry. And that's a little bit more like it from a Tipp point of view in terms of defending.
Yeah, but sure, all Cian Lynch did was tap it over the bar first time, and he got it. There was no chance of breaking through. I saw that a bit with him against Waterford as well. You know, trying to take that extra yard out of the ball. That was a simple time chance. I was just going to say he's been on the ball so much, very influential in the middle of the field, but that was an error there.
Gillan playing it in here towards Kyle Hayes. Ran away from him. Barry trying to get to it. Then it's Tom Morrissey. Plays it forward. Very good chance. Oh, it's a point and not a goal. Aaron Gillan was in like a flash that time.
That was a great ball by Tom Morrissey. You know, he should have just, he knows himself, he's shaking the head. He can't believe he didn't stick it on, or stick it in the back of the net.
Well, for a player of his class, he didn't need to play it to anybody. It was the gift opportunity presented to him, and he failed to avail of it. Morrissey, forward by Kyle Hayes again. On to Peter Casey. Again, given a little bit of space initially, and slinging it up into the air, and hitting it with accuracy. And a second point for Peter Casey, and he's going to take a bit of minding. And now Limerick have got the last 2 points, and there's just one score between the teams.
Yeah, that's a great pass to him, and you know, just shows you how you can take the sweeper out. A simple pass, good movement by Casey, and a lovely score.
Oof. Poor defending. Eventually, it's Brendan Maher who got away with that. Hit it off the Limerick player, was fortunate to get the rebound. All the way down here, which is into the hands of Declan Hannan, caught brilliantly, hoping to be the first Ahan, rather the first Adair captain for quite some time to bring the trophy back at the end of all of this.
Yeah, and you know, Tipperary, I think, playing with the breeze, they're either shooting wide from distance or playing that, you know, high ball down, and it's not suiting them. It doesn't suit that forward line. We've seen it over the years, not brilliant in the air. A big half-back line of Dermot Burns, Hannan and Dan Morris are very strong in the air, and that was a great catch by Hannan. And Dermot Burns a long way out into the breeze, but he could strike this over.
Looking to try and make it a two-point game. Well, he's missed the opportunity, and that one is the fourth wide for Limerick. It hasn't quite sparked yet, Michael.
No, still not knockout, you see, Joe. You won't get that to me all out intensity until the neck is on the line. There's a way back in for whoever loses this game today, and a little bit of that going on at the moment.
But the reward for the winner will be straight into a semi-final, about 4 weeks in which to recover any injuries and so on. Declan Hannan again for Limerick, who want to try and win here on their own patch. They don't want to lose a third championship match for the season so far, even if that would still mean that they would reach a quarter-final. Here's Casey. He's been looking good so far, but the umpire is coming to wave this one wide. Has to be content with just the 2 points he got earlier on, the 22-year-old from Napiershik.
Yeah, Limerick with some good chances as well. The other forward line causing plenty of troubles with their movement. Casey and Mulcahy all over the place, switching corners all the time.
Not sure James Barry was expecting that short puck out to come to him. Trying to get the ball into the forwards again, that doesn't work, so it's Will O'Donoghue once more, then past Kennedy, or trying to get, but Kennedy does really well. Seamus Kennedy was full-back all of last season for Tipperary, didn't play any championship hurling yet this year, but is in for the Munster final, and he means to have a really good afternoon.
Yeah, that was a great play, he hadn't much room, Jerry. Yeah, you see Kyle Hayes, a strong man coming in, but it wasn't much of a foul in it, but he got the benefit of the doubt. Both managements arguing their toss on the line there.
So once again, it's Jason Ford in his 27th championship match. Two successful frees so far. This to try and stretch the Tipperary advantage, but not with that one. It is a substantial breeze this afternoon, but it is favouring Tipperary.
It is, but I think we've seen them during the championship so far with very few wides, and you know, they've seven already this afternoon, and haven't got their shooting boots on like they normally have. They're under more pressure, less time on the ball. It makes some difference, that split second.
And even from that puck out there from Nicky Quaid, nobody able to contain it and build the next attack for Limerick. Crowd sitting back, enjoying the very nice weather we're experiencing at the moment. Looking for a few more fireworks, I think. There wasn't a ticket to be got in the last week. Everybody wanted to see this pairing of Tipp and Limerick. Last year's All-Ireland champions, the league champions, against the most informed team in Tipp. And that's gone out of play on this side. Mike Casey ready to hit the ball. Cathal McAllister is the linesman on this near side. And it's Casey himself who takes it. And the pressure is on immediately, but there's an extra player back there. Sean Finn this time, nobody to mark, so he's sweeping. Tipp waiting out in the middle third, which is fairly congested. It reaches John O'Dwyer and bobbles under pressure, hits it in, but into the goalkeeper's hands. And Nicky Quaid able to begin the counter-offensive. Out as far as Sean Finn, held onto by Kyle Hayes. Hayes down into the corner here, off Gillan. Couldn't quite get the touch to it that he needed. Patrick Maher instead. James Barry under pressure, put under an amount of pressure by Garrod Hagerty. Big, imposing wing forward. Picked up by Graham Mulcahy. Worked so well in tight spaces. Fouled, free in. Chance for Limerick to get the next score.
Yeah, and look, interesting passage of play there. Just the way the game is developing. Kyle Hayes got in a half hook on John O'Dwyer. Normally he would have tipped it over the bar. But he was operating 100 yards from the goal, won the ball, played it down into the corner, and Patrick Maher put under pressure and gave away possession there. A hard ball out to James Barry. So a lot of this, they're trying to get the perfect pass away because there's an extra man on either side. They don't want to be hitting the ball long because the sweeper's in place.
Aaron Gillan, 1 point so far, 12 points 2 weeks ago. 10 of those were from frees. And that's one of the things that Tipperary are going to have to make sure they don't do today. That is give him easy opportunities to get scores from place balls. So two for him. And it's a two-point game once again. 1-6 to 7 points.
Yeah, and interestingly, that's the first point that the Limerick have scored from a free. Tipperary, 8, Patrick Horgan scored against Cork in the first half, and 7, Gillan the last time. First.
That's a huge puck out, a really huge puck out. And Calnut was in, lurking once again. Has to be content with a point, but he could so very nearly have got his second goal of this Munster final.
And look at this, the whole length of the field practically. This is a combination of the light sliver, obviously. Look where this bounces. Inside the 14 that bounced. But that's incredible, and, maybe the sitter's not going to get any heavier because of the high-scoring matches they're having, but it is certainly a factor in the modern game.
Well, it just shows you what you can do if you can play the ball wind-assisted down there, catch the opposing defence on the hop. Tom Morrissey down here as far as Aaron Gillan again. Lovely turn. Gets away from Brendan Maher this time. Now, what can he create? What can he do with it? Here's an opportunity. Back of the net, and it's Casey. Peter Casey's second-ever championship goal. Coming after 26 minutes, and it's Limerick 1-7, Tipperary 1-7.
Yeah, look at the confidence of Gillan here. Look, the head up, and what a little flick across, and brilliant finish by Casey. The ball just down on his knees, low centre of gravity that he has. He just got down and got a lovely flick to it, and a brilliant goal for Limerick.
The teams are level for the fourth time in this Munster final. Here's Michael Breen. Tries to get away from his man, Declan Hannan. Succeeds here, trying to play it in. Dan McCormack's involved as well for Tipperary. Playing it into space here towards Ronan Maher. Runs away from him. An opportunity now for Jason Ford from open play. And Jason Ford raises a white flag with his third point of the opening half. And it's Tipperary once again back in front.
Yeah, good response by Tipp. If you watch Ronan Maher, he just let the ball run across him very cleverly. He saw Keane Lynch coming, and he just let the ball run out to Jason Ford, who was unmarked, and he kept it over the back.
This is the goal again here, which Aaron Gillan set up, and which Peter Casey completed.
Lovely little finish there, wasn't it? He just got down to the ball before it touched the ground and flicked it in.
from the puck out here. Kyle Hayes went one way to try and create space and leaves an opportunity for Tom Morrissey to advance to the 20-metre line. Oh, what a save! Brilliantly done from Garrod Hegarty's drive. That was absolutely brilliant goalkeeping by Brian Hogan. Watch this again for a rasping shot by Hegarty and an equally brilliant save by the Tipperary number one.
Absolutely, and you know, great advantage by Todd O'Dwyer there. What a save by Hogan. Tom Morrissey just fares well. Toddy Marin, I imagine, is going to get a yellow card there for that one. I didn't see whether he did or not, just I was looking away. He's calling out somebody now.
Well, it looks like it might be...
Jerry, you nailed it there. It was the movement of the Limerick half-forward and under the puck-out. They all went different directions. When the ball broke Morrissey, he was onto it like a flash. They have the edge and taste over the Tipperary defence, and certainly...
Well, the
great play by Morrissey.
The end result, Michael, is going to be a free-in rather than a 65. So this will give Limerick another chance of a score, and it should be Aaron Gillan, an easy one for him.
And Gerard, a lot of the talk coming into the game was Tipperary creating goal-scoring chances, but that's two more goals that Limerick could have had. You would have had a goal and could have had two more goals, and there's taste of their attack causing all sorts of trouble. Cathal Barrett being sorely missed back there.
Level five times in the match so far. Great saves by Brian Hogan. We saw Nicky Quaid make a great save in the match 2 weeks ago against John O'Dwyer. So now let's see what Tipperary can do with this next attack. They can't hold on to the ball from the puck out. It's Declan Hannan instead. Into space here, trying to win it was Sean O'Brien. Kennedy's there as well, trying to kick it forward with Peter Casey. Helping out here is Paddy Maher, looking to be the major influence in this game. Blocked down well by Kyle Hayes. He's doing well there, causing problems for Paddy Maher, who's usually such a major figure in all championship matches involving Tipp. Referee pointing in the direction of the Tipperary goal. Paddy Maher has a look of bewilderment on his face there. I think the ball was handled on the ground. Hence the free, which is going to be given to Limerick and which will be taken by Dermot Burns.
Yeah, and Kyle Hayes, you know, much more influential today. He's closing down of the man in possession. It's unbelievable. He covered ground so quickly. That 4 or 5 yards, he's able to get in a half hook, a block, and use his physical power. And that was another example of that, a great block down.
Dermot Burns here scored 3 points in Semple Stadium in that last match. Omitted, of course, after the game against Cork, but reacted very quickly, very positively when he was reinstated. And he's got an opening point here from that free. And he now makes it 1-9 to 1-8. Limerick in front.
Yeah, Jerry, you have to say they're by far the better team. You know, they're probably worth a 4 or 5 point lead at this stage. And they're playing into the breeze, but it's a much different Limerick than we've seen so far in the championship.
This time it's Mike Casey standing back, winning it. Always likes to take it out here, but the challenge came in there from McCormack, still managed to get that ball away. James Barry now under pressure from Graham Mulcahy, still got it down, but it's a poor clearance. Credit Mulcahy maybe for the inaccuracy. Back it comes from Dan Morrissey again, up towards Gillan. Slinging that pass back in here and taking it was Tom Morrissey, a little block on it. They win it again, Limerick, with Graham Mulcahy twisting this way and that, and the referee says you took too many steps and it's going to be a free against you. Shake of the head from the Kilmallock player.
Yeah, we just saw what Gillan does. He's so strong as well, he's been a great hurler. He held off Brendan Maher, won the ball, gave it to Tom Morrissey, and he felt he should have got it over. Toddy Maher got in a good block, but Mulcahy, I thought that was a lovely bit of skill, probably held on to that a little bit long. He was jinking, making room for himself, and there was no space.
About 4 minutes to go to half-time. Free taken by Brian Hogan. Looking to try and set Tipperary up for the next score. It's Jake Morris. Hasn't scored so far. And that one got a block on it. It's going to be Richie English. Takes control, hits it into the ground. Lynch forward here as far as Garrod Hegarty. He must be still wondering why he didn't score a goal a few minutes ago. Will O'Donoghue, that was a poor hand pass. Straight towards... Jason Ford, that then intercepting Limerick, and Dan Morrissey. On it comes again with Kyle Hayes. Hayes once more causing major problems. Hand passing it back here towards Graham Mulcahy, then losing his way. Nobody quite able to take firm control of the slitter. Eventually it is picked up with great difficulty. Brendan Maher trying to get that ball out. And then there was a foul committed, and the referee has signalled a free to Tipperary.
You know, if a passage of play sums up the modern game, look at the ferociousness of the tackle. I'm sure there's a lot. Look at the amount of Limerick players around the ball. Their power and pace is unbelievable. Hegarty was back here 50 yards from his own goal just maybe 4 or 5 seconds ago. They're covering ground, and that half forward line back in place today. Hegarty, Hayes, and Tom Morrissey doing what they do so well.
So little space or so little time available to for anybody nowadays to really do anything. It's, as you say, so condensed.
The Tipperary really struggling to win any possession, you know. Lynch and Will O'Donoghue. Will O'Donoghue in particular, he's absolutely flying around the place. He's winning an awful lot of ball. Michael Breen and Noel McGrath, hardly been mentioned. Normally McGrath, such an important link man for them. He's not in the game, so they're getting no possession, no ball into John McGrath or Callan. And Tipperary, I think, even though they're playing with the breeze, will be delighted running a point behind.
Kyle Hayes is okay. As you mentioned, Will O'Donoghue is having a very good match so far. A player who played very little championship hurling before the start of this season. Free coming up to Tipperary, and Noel McGrath looking to try and set up John O'Dwyer, but a no-nonsense challenge came in immediately there, and Limerick have it back again. Mulcahy taking it from Cian Lynch, then in as far as Gillan, back in once more towards Garroyd Hegarty, up into the air, but lacking accuracy. Another one has gone astray, and that's six wides by Limerick, who've had the better of things and lead by a point coming close to half-time. Brian Hogan landing this one down there, taking it brilliantly was Dermot Burns. Back out to Will O'Donoghue again, then it's Cian Lynch forward as far as Garroyd Hegarty. Lovely passing movement by Limerick, that is spectacular, but it's gone wide. One umpire looked at another just to make absolutely sure.
Well, I think it was Garroyd Hegarty. That's two in a row, you can see that clearly outside the post. And what a piece of play, though. Dermot Burns dominate. I mentioned Hannan and Morris as well, but particularly Burns and Hannan are on so much ball.
Missed there in the air by Sean Finn. Needs his fullback to come across. Mike Casey just holding it. Barely mentioned John McGrath in this game so far. Don't think he's had a touch. Tipperary need a big improvement in the second half if they're to win the first Munster Championship for some 3 years. They beat Waterford here on a damp afternoon in 2016. That time, Ronan Marr hitting it. It's one they needed. Ronan Marr with a second point of the first half, and the teams are level.
That sums up hurling. Garrett Hegarty had him on the runaround for 2 points he should have put over the bar. He bought him wide, and Marr gets one chance from 100 yards and straight over the bar. What a great striker he is.
This is played into space here. Richie English, the cornerback, was making a darting run out of defence. Left the ball behind. Michael Breen's left his hurley behind. Goes trying to kick it forward. Eventually, Garroyd Hegarty goes forward, puts the head down. Touched away from him by Ronan Marr. Under pressure again. Hegarty once more. It's still Hegarty. Hand pass to his left to Mulcahy. He's got a man over on the left-hand side. If he can reach Gillan, he's also got Tom Morrissey there, and it's Tom Morrissey from the edge of the D who completes the move, although he has injured his hand in the process. 1-9 to 1-10 to 1-9.
Brendan Marvel, he went to block him down. Great play by Mulcahy, well closed down, but Tom Morrissey there in support. And just a slap came in there just as he was hitting the ball over the bar.
Yeah,
ref taking no action.
There's a challenge there late on as Tom Morrissey was hitting that one. And as you say, a belt to the hand. Looks like he's going to be able to continue. Five different scorers so far for Limerick. Five of their six attackers, that is. Also Cian Lynch and Dermot Burns, of course, from a free. James Barry now. Into open space, but nobody in a Tipperary shirt there to collect it. Instead, it was Peter Casey who was battling to try and take possession against Noel McGrath. McGrath goes down. Here comes Sean O'Brien to get the ball forward. It's very helter-skelter, as I mentioned, in the middle third, without a great deal of fluency at times. Of a real battle between these two teams, and Limerick shading it by a point.
Abitur, the ferociousness of the tackling there for Limerick. It's unbelievable. They're not giving Limerick. Tipperary are... they're dazed at the moment. They get in the early rounds of the championship, they were working that ball out lovely, picking out the pass. They've been closed down within milliseconds out there. It's just brilliant display by Limerick. Their forwards working really, really hard, and Will O'Donoghue coming in there again and took a high challenge and won the free.
John Kiley was questioned about his rotation of the players in recent weeks, but right now he's got his best team out there. Dermot Burns to hit this one. Straight as you could wish. Nice elevation, nice score. Limerick lead by two. And there's the half-time whistle. Tipperary had the breeze for the opening 35 minutes, but didn't do quite enough with it. It was Limerick who were the better team by and large. They had several goal chances. We saw Seamus Cowan score a goal after 18 minutes. That was his 32nd ever goal. Peter Casey then some 8 minutes later for Limerick. And at half-time here in Cork na Gael in Limerick in the 2019 Munster hurling final, it is Limerick who are leading Tipperary. The halftime score, Limerick 1-11, Tipperary 1-9, and we'll be looking back on the key moments of the first half with our panel right after this.
It is Limerick with the advantage at halftime, 1-11 to 1-9. Great spread of scores for both sides as well. And here in Croke Park in the Joe McDonagh final, Laois in the early stages of the second half currently lead Westmeath 2-11 to 1-11. So that sounds like a... In fact, it's 2-11 to 1-12 now. Westmeath just added another point, so that's clearly a great battle as well. But let's get straight into what happened in the Gaelic grounds. Tipperary started off better, but no doubt about it that Limerick got on top. But that goal for Seamus Callanan looked like it might set Tipp well on the way.
Yeah, it was probably centre of the first 15 minutes. You know, quick free, Limerick had switched off. They'd started slow, Tipp were well on top. Dermot Burns put in a half-hour effort to try and get back. He creates a space. I think I like about this is that Seamus Callanan is a goal scorer. He wants to go for it. He could have easily tipped it over the bar. He waited. He made the Limerick lad. Sean Finn didn't know whether to go or stay. And it just an exquisite finish. Look at the way he just bounced it in front. The extra touch there just got him in closer and just bounced in front of Nicky Quaid. He'd no chance.
As usual, we obviously teed up Aaron Galan and his influence. We were wondering what would be done about him. Brendan Maher, the man, it would appear, for the opposition strongmen, went in, and that's been a brilliant battle, has it?
Yeah, Joanne, we couldn't anticipate Brendan Maher to be the man to go back. Now, he obviously did a great job on Tony Kelly. And for a long, you know, for 27, 8 minutes of this match, Brendan Maher so tight to Aaron Galan. I see Kyle Hayes here. Brilliant ball, the usual type ball. Brendan is so tight, he's just leaving it there for Paddy to pick up, but eventually the boy, when he gets a bit of space.
Yeah, and this is where Brendan Maher, he saw himself, he went to his right side, Galan came back into his left. Again, like Seamus Cannon, looking to see, can we create a goal here? And just watch this finish, you know, Peter Casey was on top form. You know, that was a very, very difficult goal to score. And for any young boy at home, our girl, the way he shortened his hurdle, very similar to Galan to get the flick away. He's looking to see if he can create a goal, and just a brilliant finish again into the bottom corner.
Joanne, would a natural fullback have been, too tight?
It went.
You know, he'd give the yard and stand him up. He got in, you know, a wing back's tackle nearly, I would have thought. Yeah. A natural fullback line man probably would have allowed a little gap and say, a point at worst, or I might block you down.
And the good inside forwards actually like that. Exactly, they use that. Use that momentum and spin off. It's a great point, Anthony.
Just one goal for Limerick in that first half. Surely they should have had more.
Yeah, they definitely had other chances. It looked as if they were causing fierce problems down the middle. Cian Lynch has been getting on a lot of balls, going inside the Tipperary half-back line. I think Brian Hogan deserves great credit here. He probably thought it was going to be a rocket. First one should be set, but the second one, bravery. Like, there wasn't a question. He was coming straight out to that ball, taking the belt wherever he had to take it. And here, you see Tom Morrissey, really good, short hand pass. Unless that ball struck off Tipperary, the Tipperary defender coming across Maher, he should have got a goal in that situation. Again, you see Limerick coming through. Hagerty comes on. Look, I don't want to take anything from Brian Hogan. That's an outstanding save. Remember, we talk about the ball, how fast it can travel now. The distance that's there was very narrow. In an ideal world, we were talking about it here, the other side was open, but don't want to take that in the way. It was an outstanding save from Brian Hogan.
OK, just the 2 points in it at the break in the Gaelic ground.
Tipp were well on top. You know, there was three puckers in a row where Tipp had clean catches, and that was setting the template for them pushing forward, and that was the time. But Limerick have kind of evolved over there. They went a couple of short. You know, their stats and puckouts is 10 from 17, while Tipperary, who've been going long, very long, have only won 7 out of their 18. So the template has been set. And once Limerick get a foothold on the game, they transition so well through the lines. And the one thing for me about the Tipperary forwards, we were always concerned the legs, and I think today they look a bit tired. And missing Bonner as well, that ferocious work rate and turnovers. Barrett. And Barrett, obviously, inside. But in the forwards, to turn over that middle third.
Yeah, but you're taking Brendan out of the half-back line as well. Like,
exactly.
You know, so.
Yeah, Brendan and James Barry in the corner as well. But I just think that ferocious kind of work rate, the Tipp have shown up to now, probably is not in place today so far.
Do they have the legs around the middle third
as
well?
Thing. That's
you know
the thing.
What I mean? We're all conscious of that. Maybe even Noel McGrath, he's an outstanding hurler, but he just doesn't strike you as having maybe the same legs as some of
well,
the people.
Well, you look at the goal chances you showed before the break. It was Limerick cutting through the lines, breaking through the channels, and they were just leaving the Tipperary
the last
away.
12, 13 minutes, Joanne, the amount of turnovers they've forced in the middle, and they'll be relentless, like they're younger. They won't deviate now from the plan, even though they've a big wind at their back now. They won't get dragged up the field like and play a three man inside. Kinnerk won't allow that, like, you know, and it's hard to see them being beaten from here, but when you get in a hurling match sometimes you'll get X amount of chances, and if you don't take them it can come back to haunt you.
Yeah, Tipp will have a period, and their best hope now is that they can get the interchange goals, and a bit of stuff that might give them hope is, like Anthony's point, against the wind there might be more chance for that interplay to occur in the forward line, but they'll need more goals the way this game is going.
Just to pick you up on about you're saying how about Limerick got so much on top around that middle section. But at the start of the match, Tipperary were swarming all over them and winning plenty of those battles as well. So, I mean, they obviously have it in them.
But their half-back line was dominating. So Nicky Quaid was going long a lot of the time, and their half-back line was dominating that period. And it didn't give the opportunity for the ball to be broken down there, and Tipperary just took advantage of that. But since, I think they've kind of settled a little bit more and they have been able to do that interplay, as Donal has spoken about, that's when, you know, Limerick have really got on top.
Yeah, we saw the best of Limerick, really, the best parts of their game in that 15 minutes. But it goes back to what we spoke about, Joanne. This is multi-dimensional. These are all connected parts. Other areas in the field, if your half-back line is not playing well, then your half-forward line are going to be in trouble, and so on.
But I don't think Liam will be too happy with his forwards inside. I just think the work rate is not at the levels we've seen before.
Well, it was for a while, Henry.
At the beginning. But I don't know if Limerick were...
It's definitely gotten missing. And like... I'd say, Joanne, some people are saying 110, 108, not a classic Munster final. For me, that's ferocious there. I'll tell you, the belting, the hooking, the blocking that's going on out there. Fellas will wake up tomorrow morning. They might have time for a couple of beers tonight, but they won't be worried about the pain they had for the couple of beers. It'll be the pain they'll have everywhere. Every sinew will be aching there. From the fellas around the middle, and the likes of Will O'Donoghue has hit nearly everything that has moved in the middle there, Kyle Hayes.
Well, one man in the middle is Michael Breen, but he's not anymore because he's being replaced by Niall O'Mara for the second half. And you may have heard a big roar behind us here while we were talking a little while ago. That's because Leash scored a third goal in this Joe McDonagh final, so they lead Westmead 3-14 to 1-15 at the moment. It started 15 minutes earlier than the Munster final, so it's well into the second half there. Let's head back for the second half in the LIT Gaelic Grounds with Michael and Jarve.
Second half about to get underway. Niall O'Mara on in place of Michael Breen. And it's Tipperary who go into the attack immediately with Dan McCormack. And passing it back, intended for Noel McGrath, but seized on instead by Cian Lynch. Two between them, remember. Limerick 1-11, Tipperary 1-9. Tipperary with six different scorers in the first half. Limerick with seven, and the teams were level on some six occasions.
You know, that little passage summed up maybe the way the first half ended. You know, Limerick or Tipperary win the possession, but just couldn't get away from the Limerick lads. They hounded them, tracked them, put them under pressure, and Dan McCormack throws away a hand pass, and Lynch is sweeping back behind them and picks it up.
So once again, it's going to be Dermot Byrne here in this wonderful stadium in Limerick. Packed to capacity this afternoon. An LIT student himself hitting this free. Walked away immediately confident. Knew it was going exactly where he intended it to go. And it's his third of the day so far. And Limerick stretch their lead to three.
Yeah, he makes them look so easy. What a beautiful natural striker he is. A huge man. He's having a super game today.
Tipperary have work to do, but they always knew it was going to be difficult coming here to beat Limerick on their home patch. In fact, Tipperary have lost their last four matches in all different competitions at the Gaelic Grounds as Dan McCormack hits his shot wide. A couple of metres wide of that left-hand target. That's eight wides now in all by Tipperary. It's a lot, and he knows it.
Yeah, an easy chance for him, and you get the feeling they're going to need him. A couple of Limerick players hobbling. Keane Lynch is hobbling in the middle of the field, and there's somebody else down injured.
That's Will O'Donoghue.
Will O'Donoghue,
Michael.
Yeah. I just see Keane Lynch just Hoblins is the throw-in as well.
And they're the two midfield players, of course, Lynch and O'Donoghue. They've got one obvious sub to come in, should he be required, Dara O'Donovan.
Yeah, they've been hugely influential, as we mentioned, in the first half, both of them well on top.
Puck out for Limerick, for Nicky Quaid. He's got the wind behind him now for the second half. Gathered in here and then dropped by Ronan Marr. Able to start again, runs into the challenge of Kyle Hayes, or rather it's not Kyle Hayes, this time it's Peter Casey. But Kyle Hayes, I think, has just changed his helmet, gone to a black helmet. Tipperary trying to get something going in here. They've got possession. It's Seamus Calnan. He's got a player in support to require him, but Calnan decides to go it himself and has missed the opportunity. Scorer of a goal and a point in the opening 35 minutes.
And Noel McGrath was very anxious to take that one quickly. A brilliant take by Callan in the first, but I think if he just looked across, it was Jake Morris completely free in front of the goals before he turned away.
That's well caught. Brilliantly done by Kyle Hayes. Slips it as far as Garrod Hagerty, and Hagerty, quick as you would wish, has gone over the bar with that one. Point in each half.
Kyle Hayes, change of helmet. The white one has gone down to black one for the second half. What a catch. And just the speed of the hand pass to Hagerty coming off his shoulder. That's a great point.
Limerick's last win here in the Munster Championship was on home soil against Cork back in 2013. They're looking to win it again. A victory for them would be a 20th ever Munster title, but there's a lot of work to do. Garrod Hagerty starts. Hagerty starting the second half well, in determined fashion. Tipperary put on the pressure, however. John McGrath trying to get that ball forward. The referee allows play to continue. Tipperary players questioning whether or not a foul had occurred. Declan Hannan gets on with his business, drives it away down towards Aaron Gillan. Gillan backing in towards the end line, and the ball has gone wide.
Yeah, and Declan Hannan acknowledging that was a mistake. You know, he should have played that in. But I didn't see any free. Great tackling by the Limerick backs there in the last passage.
Brendan Maher gets this one out. Jake Morris sees it go back here as far as Ronan Maher. Maher again, that's a hit in the air there, brilliantly by John O'Dwyer, but all the way back, and the referee is blowing his whistle. There's a Limerick player injured on the sideline here. Attention given immediately to the injured player.
Yeah, it was John O'Dwyer. The ball was thrown high, hand pass to him, and he went to pull in the ball here.
Let's just have a look at this again, Michael. Ooh,
that was late. And
very.
He wasn't looking where he was pulling. It was a wild stroke and hit Dermot Byrne straight in the fire. Depends what the linesman saw there. But
the linesman is James Owens. And the referee is going to call John O'Dwyer across here. And the colour of the card is going to be of interest here. The referee is speaking to him. It would suggest he's going to leave him on and give him a yellow. And that is the case. Well, he didn't look to be looking, as you say, as that ball was in the air and he played it against Dermot Burns and made contact with the wing back of Limerick. Burns back on his feet, by the way. It's going to be a free from where the ball has landed. There you are. And Burns himself is going to take it.
Well, what I'd say there, Gerard, is, you know, the ball was in the air. He wasn't sure. But when you're not sure, I don't think you can just pull the hurl like that, you know. And he was lucky enough. He hit him in the head and another ref could have shown him a red card.
Easily. Limerick have hit six of the last seven scores in this match. Burns once again called into action, an LIT student, and that one has drifted away outright.
Well, as I said many times over the years, any lad that gets a belt, I wouldn't have him taken the next 3 years. That was well within Aaron Gillan's. You get a belt in the head like that, it takes a bit out of you and takes a couple of minutes to recover.
Brian Hogan's puck out, landing there on the 45-metre line, picked up by Will O'Donoghue. Hooked, goes again, strongly built man, anxious to make the most of the opportunities given to him. That was Niall O'Mara feeding it forward there. Dermot Burns going back towards his own goal, clashing with Calden there. Out came Mike Casey to get that ball away as far as Will O'Donoghue. And then it is Dan Morrissey firing it down to top of the right. There are two Limerick players there, just one from Tipperary. And it's Aaron Gillan. He had a player inside him, it was Kian Lynch. There's still possibilities. Kyle Hayes. Oh! My goodness, how did that stay out? Another amazing goal opportunity for Limerick. Away quickly by Jake Morris.
as far as Dan McCormack. Down in there in a chase for possession involving Jason Ford and the man in the corner who's Sean Finn. Finn and Ford. Eventually it's Ford stopped in his tracks. Unfairly, the referee has decided, and it's going to be a free in.
Well, Jared, another passage to play, another goal chance for Limerick. Kyle Hayes just, and Gallan just looked up and picked them out. I don't think there was any free initially there, but I think if you watch when Ford wins the ball back here, he's trying to drive forward and he just held up there, and the ref gives a free in. But another clear goal chance for Limerick at the other end of the field. There's only been one team in it for about the last 20, 25 minutes. Limerick completely dominating, and yet they're only 4 points up, and this should be back to three now.
Looking for their first point of the second half. Jason Ford, three in the first half. And he's got the scoring going again for Tipperary. But just look at what happened a few moments earlier.
And here's Hayes, cuts inside, and again, a brilliant save by Brian Hogan. But really, at this level, someone like Kyle Hayes should be sticking that in the corner of the net, and the goalie shouldn't make any difference. But that was a very good save, and Hogan is keeping Tipperary in this game big time.
As the panel were mentioning at half-time, you can have these opportunities, and if you don't take them by the end of the 70 minutes, you may well be paying the cost. Tipperary still very much in it, only three behind. Ronan Marr gets it across here as far as Dan McCormack. He's working really, really hard, showing great industry. The referee has allowed an advantage, and it's forward as far as John McGrath. McGrath in and scoring! Didn't touch the ball for the opening 35 minutes, but the man who got 3-2 here in his last Munster final 3 years ago has put the team's level.
Well, you have to give huge credit to Ronan Marr. He took a savage tackle, but look at McGrath, never touched the ball so far in the game, and that's the difference. That's the first chance he's got. He doesn't miss, sticks it in the roof of the net, draw a match all of a sudden.
Level for the seventh time here in the Gaelic grounds. John McGrath up at the other end. There's defending to do, and Brendan Marr manages to get it away up into the middle of the park. Racing to get it here is Will O'Donoghue. Kian Lynch trying to keep it moving, has a support option available to him. That was Kyle Hayes, blocked immediately. Down come Tipperary, John O'Dwyer, beautifully picked up here by Jason Ford over his left shoulder, and they look at it and watch it go wide of the target. That's 10 wides by Tipperary.
Yeah, poor option. Here's the goal again by McGrath, brilliant finish, but that's a poor option there by Jason Ford. Jake Morris was outside him, should have just turned his man, stood him up and created a play out of that.
Exciting play at the start of this second half. Tom Morrissey nicely down. Peter Casey, lovely control, works so well. Lovely ease of movement and a great skill demonstrated again. A goal and three now for him. And Limerick back in front once more.
Yeah, I was talking to TJ Ryan on the way in, the former Limerick player and manager, and he said to me the reason Casey's on this team is in training every night, he's outstanding. 1-3, he's given James Barry a runner.
Forward they come once more. Will O'Donoghue. Brilliant play, Lynch supporting him expertly, the timing was superb, and that time it was racing out there to get it, Brendan Maher. Under pressure here is Sean O'Brien, supported there by Toddy Maher. Maher touching it, then knocked in the back, down he goes, gets up immediately, play continues, it's tough, it's ferocious, it's the Munster final, it's what you expect.
And that was some hit there, I think it was Graham Mulcahy on Toddy Maher, I don't know if it was legal or not, but it, just watch Toddy Maher picking the ball up here, loses possession, and in comes Mulcahy with a hit on him, and Maher is still down injured. Referee doesn't want to know about it, he's telling him to get up.
He got up, and then he realised how tough a blow it had been, and the physio and doctor are in to attend to him immediately. But this was the goal again.
He's born to score goals, it's a great goal. Tipperary in it against run of play, but defer to Limerick, they came back down the field and scored a point, responded well.
What you have to admire about John McGrath, he may be quiet for quite a long phase of a game, but then when a goal opportunity comes along, as you suggest, he senses it, and he delivers each time. It's going to be Garrow Tegarty who will hit the resultant ball here for Limerick. 1:14 to 2:10. Tip fans saying, come on, hurry it up, Garroyd. He does eventually, but hits it straight to a Tipperary man, to Ronan Marr. Out as far as Noel McGrath, rolls it low in there cleverly towards Jake Morris, can't get to it. Instead, it's picked up again by Tom Morrissey. Limerick with Graham Mulcahy feeding it in there as far as Declan Hannan, low in towards Aaron Gillan, trying to get the measure of the cornerback here, and the referee sees a foul by Sean O'Brien, and it's going to be a free in.
What's Brendan?
It's Brendan Maher, in fact.
I don't think he fouled there at all. He kept his hands away from his jersey, and I think that's a soft free for Limerick.
Limerick will see it as a bit of a gift, and Tipperary with Brendan Maher still there questioning that, understandably so. An opportunity, however, for Limerick to tag on another score, and it'll be Aaron Gillan, scorer of 3 points already in this final, two of them from frees. Well, they'll all count, and he's got a fourth here, and he pushes Limerick a little bit further ahead once again, 115 to 210, 18 points to 16. Noel McGrath, with some difficulty, picks that one up, floats it out there as far as Seamus Kennedy. Jumping and winning this one is Mike Casey, getting it back out once again as far as Dermot Burns. Great ball, huge ball, down towards Gillan again it comes. Challenge there by Brendan Maher. Out once more it comes via the Tipperary defence. Out into the middle as far as Noel McGrath. Over here waiting for it, unmarked, totally unmarked, Jake Morris. Inside towards Calden. It's Calden there against Sean Finn. Little block on it by Finn, that's effective enough. Richie English comes across to try and help the other cornerback, and eventually Finn gets it out into the centre to Hannan, further out as far as Kean Lynch, and Limerick lift the storm and once again try to get that attack going. Stopped over there by James Barry, coming under pressure there from Tom Morrissey, and the referee again blows his whistle and gives another free, and Limerick are querying it once more.
And watch Seamus Callan here. Sean Finn, a great block, but outside there, you see Bubbles at work. When Callan got the ball first, all he did was throw a simple hand pass out. Bubbles was very frustrated with it, didn't get the pass, and it was an easy score on.
Paddy Maher taking the free, won by Limerick again. It's Dermot Burns into Will O'Donoghue. Taken once more by Limerick. Hannan getting it out, flicking it out as far as Mike Casey. Casey once again going on a solo run as far as his brother Peter. Two players have starred for the Piershig in the club championships. And then over his shoulder, looking at the target, measuring it beautifully, he's got a goal and four. He really is on fire and justifying his selection this year by John Kiley and the management team.
Yeah, that's just a brilliant score. And James Maher in all sorts of trouble, been dragged all over Gaelic grounds by Casey. And he's just having one of those days that we've seen so often in the club.
Limerick by three. And the last time that Limerick were ahead by three, John McGrath got the ball in his hands and struck the back of the Limerick net. What's going to happen next? Jason Ford to eat into the lead. It's back to a two-point game. Ford's got five.
Yeah, Tipperary getting a little bit more room up front. We've seen Jake Morris in loads of space a couple of times, but you have to be very impressed with Limerick, the way they responded to that goal. But Tipperary just staying in it, picking off an odd point, and very, very dangerous all the time.
Kyle Hayes couldn't contain that one. Noel McGrath able to feed it forward, but not linking up with anybody in the inside forward line, only finding Richie English instead. Back they go. Graham Mulcahy came across, won it, hits it, looks at his work and sees the white flag, and that's his first point in the match.
Sure, that's a great score. What Tariq Maher waited for that ball, it was dropping down and in nip Mulcahy, and that's what he does so well, and put it over. That's all six Limerick forwards now have scored from play.
It's the eighth time that Mulcahy is facing Tipperary in the championship. Only three wins so far, hoping this will be the day he gets his hands again on a Munster medal. Tipperary will battle right to the end, you may be sure. James Barry, Tip unbeaten in the championship so far, but a stern test being presented this afternoon by Limerick, as anticipated. Declan Hannan floating it into the corner here, where Garrod Hagerty has drifted out, trying to link up with Gillan, cut out instead by his marker. Brendan Maher did such a very good job in the game against Clare a few weeks ago. In as far as Noel McGrath, out to the corner once more, trying to stretch things, but where he goes, Sean Finn goes as well, keeping it away there from Jason Ford initially, Ford chases after it, gets there, can't take it. McGrath tries to get to it, then eventually it's Dan Morrissey. And that is a big shot, it's a huge one, it's got over the bar, and it's Tom Morrissey who's got it, a second for him this afternoon.
Well, if a score sums up maybe why Limerick are Ireland champions, it's that one. Sean Finn, you know, lovely ball into space in front of Jason Ford, but Finn had the pace to beat him to it, to work the ball out, ferocious tackling again, and then Tom Morrissey in full flow straight over the bar. Great score, and that's what makes this Limerick backline, I think, so impressive. The pace of their cornerbacks, their hurling ability. When English and Finn get the ball, or Mike Casey, they're looking up and they're playing hurling. They're not just driving it down the field and Tipperary moving their forwards all over the place, but it's not working for them. You know, Callanan, John McGrath winning an odd ball, but the rest of the forwards out of it.
Bad puck out. It's Limerick again, ready to penalise Tipperary, and Graham Mulcahy this time hitting it wide. It's some 10 wides now by Limerick as well. It's Limerick with 7 different points in this second half. Just 3 scores for Tipperary, a goal and 2. They need more to try and stay in this final in a meaningful way. Limerick lording it. Again, it's McGrath back there, feeding it cleverly, back as far as Sean O'Brien, on as far as Jake Morris. Morris hitting it, one Tipperary need. Can he get it? He can. His opening point of the game.
Yeah, very good score, nice ball into his feet. And you have Morris and Niall O'Mara, the two wing forwards at the moment, you know, so Tipperary can't go long.
Once more, it's Tom Morrissey looking to try and replicate what he did a little while ago.
Just saying, you have Niall O'Mara, Jason Ford, and Jake Morris is the half forward line for Tipperary now. They have no chance in the air against that half back line of Limerick. So Limerick know that. So Tipperary trying to go short, and Limerick forward is closing them down really, really quickly. And that's Noel McGrath going. He's struggling a bit with the pace of the game here today. Robert Byrne got in there. But you know, Limerick tactically now, they know that Tipperary are going to have to try to go short because they're going to struggle to win that high ball in the air.
Well, Robert Byrne, one of the young players who did so well last year in the Under-21 Championship, which was won by Tipperary. Graham Mulcahy doing well here. Down towards Gillan once again. Once more, his marker has pinched that ball away. Brendan Maher. Out it comes to Paulrig Maher. Firing it forward once more. Tipp will always believe that there are possibilities for them to get scores, but not if Mike Casey has his way. Showing good awareness of the position of Will O'Donoghue in support of him. Garrett Hagerty racing back to try and get to it. Paulrig Maher got there first. And Brendan Maher, his namesake, plays it forward, but not too far. It's Garrett Hagerty for Limerick, trying to feed it in once more. James Barry has that ball stolen away from him by Casey. Onto it comes Hayes. There's another one for Limerick. Kyle Hayes. A goal after 55 minutes.
Watch James Barry here. Look, taking the extra touch. At this level, you can't do that. Brilliant flick away from him. And Hayes has been threatening this all day. He's been covered. Just watch the extra touch. Should have been in his hand. Great flick away by Casey. And in comes Kyle Hayes and made no mistake this time.
2:18 to 2:12. Well, their fans will believe at this stage of the game, with a quarter of an hour to go, that it has to be Limerick. Cian Lynch with Will O'Donoghue, quite a partnership in the middle of the field, working extremely hard. Peter Casey, who's been on fire, this one has got away from him. He's arguing the point, he's got a goal and 4. He set up that last goal there for Kyle Hayes, and he still believes that he was on target. Look at that for a piece of robbery. And look at this for a calm finish.
And Hayes has just been immense. You know, his ability to close down Tipperary forwards every time they get the ball, or Tipperary backs, every time they get the ball, he's the man that's making up that 4 or 5 yards and putting them under serious pressure.
Well, questions were asked about Limerick 2 weeks ago when they went to Thurles to take on Tipperary, and Tipperary did so much that was good and that was right. And they won by 4 points, that wide by Dermot Burns. What is this now telling us about Tipperary? They were the favourites to win the All-Ireland.
They were, and you know, Limerick rotated. John Kiley takes a lot of credit. He's recreated that hunger in the panel. But their power and their taste today, top class. Look, still 15 minutes to go. Game of hurling, a lot can happen, but they dominate all over the field at this stage.
And that domination is illustrated once again here by Richie English, who got to that, took a knock from Niall O'Mara, then still managed to get it down. A bit of concentration there, lapsing by Peter Casey, 22 years of age. Well, John Kiley, as you say there, and Paul Kinnerk alongside him, take an awful lot of credit. And they're beginning to enjoy it now here. The tension may have lifted from them. Remember only a couple of weeks ago that Limerick were here against Clare, and if they lost that afternoon, they were out of the championship. Lock, stock and barrel. Tipperary were flying at that stage. Niall O'Mara, needing support, gets it from Sean O'Brien. Darts forward again then, past Kian Lynch. Then it's hit into space here for Callanan to race in. He must score, he will. Oh, somehow it's stopped by the goalkeeper. Another miracle save by Mickey Quaid. Resourcefully using his legs that time to deny Seamus Callanan a second goal in this match. That would have changed the complexity of this Munster final quite considerably. Forimar again. Back here to James Barry, who's had a tough afternoon. They all have had. Morris, ooh, he wasn't expecting that one. Back in came Kyle Hayes to dispossess him with a shoulder, then hit it off as far as Kian Lynch, who finishes in style. Two for Lynch, another for Limerick, all over the park. Tipperary are struggling to withstand the ferocity of Limerick's challenge.
You saw Lynch again. Brilliant save by the foot there by Quaid. He got down. Shane McCallan doesn't normally miss those. But Kyle Hayes again, I mentioned him just a second. The shoulder hit Jack Mercer, drove him out of the way and flicked it to Lynch, and that's surely it now. That lifted the whole crowd. 7 points in it now instead of could have been back to three.
O'Donoghue in here as far as Casey. Such quick feet. Off he goes. Change of direction then. Sean O'Brien chasing a shadow. Oh, that is superb. That is magnificent. So many heroes in this Limerick team this afternoon, and he's certainly one of them.
That's an incredible score. He knew all the time what he was doing. You know, just flicked it on in front of himself again. But here's Callanan now, straight through, had all the time in the world. And look at that for Quaid. Again, should have been in the back of the net, but Quaid just got his foot out, kept his eye on the ball, eyes wide open there, and that's a great save, but it should have been in the net.
When have you seen Callanan miss like that, Michael?
It doesn't.
It doesn't happen. And that is Garroyd Hegarty, and I think everything that they're touching right now is turning to gold, and he's got a third, and all around the park they are utterly dominant. And absolutely brilliant. Yep. The All-Ireland, the league champions, set to be the Munster champions.
Look at Hayes again closing down. It's savage to tackle another foul.
Still about 11 minutes to go in this match, plus a bit of stoppage time. It's a real challenge for Tipperary right now. And Robert Byrne in there, trying to win that when he succeeds. Gives it to Dan McCormack, fires it in. But Limerick's backs are first to everything. Richie English out quickly. Then it's Mulcahy being provider, gives it back there to Dan Morrissey this time. And that one is fired away, left of the target.
Yeah, and we were talking, you know, during the week, and I was talking about Tipperary scoring options, their forwards from play. But look at today, Hegarty with three, Kyle Hayes 1-1, Tom Morrissey 2. Galan only one from play. I suppose Brendan Maher doing a brilliant job on Galan generally. He's the only Tipperary defender that's really... you know, having a great battle with his man, the rest of them getting well beaten.
Limerick with some 23 scores so far and 14 wides into the bargain as well. And now a line ball to Tipperary, and Liam Sheedy is in to place it there as it went off Aaron Gillard. More changes been made, and Tipperary are bringing on Jerome Cahill. And coming off is John O'Dwyer, wasn't his day. Jerome Cahill coming in for a first championship match. He's from Kilruane MacDonagh's. There were questions beforehand about Tipperary insofar as they had a very, very good starting 15. After that, people wondered about the strength of their panel and the extent to which they had been given opportunities during the round robin in Munster. Right now it's Limerick, who look much fresher. Kian Lynch playing it in here. Sean O'Brien thought about leaving it to his goalkeeper. Back out it comes instead here as far as James Barry. Dan McCormack. Nicely taken forward here, but the man has just come on, Jerome Cahill. Catching up with him, however, was Kyle Hayes. Welcome to senior hurling. And wriggling away from that was Will O'Donoghue, helped out by Richie English. Back again to Dan Morrissey. Dan fancies what doing what the brother has already done. Umpires look at it, but wave it wide.
That's the second one of them. And look at, here's Shane Dowling and Darragh Donovan coming on now as well. Just shows that the backup is going to start now. The Cavalry are going to come in, and Limerick already with a 9-point lead.
That is some bench to be able to use some of those
players. Talk about the players, you know, the amount of players you have and the good forwards that Tipperary have, which they have. But if you're not getting the ball, if you're not getting the chance to get your head up in the half-back in our midfield to supply that ball, and that's all down to the ferociousness, the pace, the athleticism, the passion of the Limerick forwards in midfield who dominated this game.
Just look at the way the Limerick fans here have responded to the players who are coming off the field, who have done their job, and they gave a big, big salute to Will O'Donoghue, who was terrific in midfield. And the other player going off has got to be Tom Morrissey. Oh, I see. Is that Garroyd Hagerty coming off? It looks to be... It is Garroyd Hagerty who's off at the moment. Got a number 12 had been raised there. So it's 19 for 10. That's Shane Dowling who's come on in place of Garroyd Hagerty. It's not going to get any bit easier for Tipperary, that's absolutely for sure. Darragh O'Donovan now in the middle of the field there with those red boots in the thick of the action, flicks it back towards Cian Lynch, then he challenges. Lynch has it, however, out here as far as Shane Dowling. Dowling, oof, that was a challenge there by Ronan Marr. Down went Peter Casey, caught by the arm of Ronan Marr. It's gone wide, the referee is going to hold the play here. Attention will be required. Just watch this again. That was a very high elbow. That is dangerous.
That's straight into the head, and if that was seen, that's it.
That's a red card offence.
Yeah, he left the ground and jumped straight into him.
Limerick with 1-3 for the last 10 minutes and no response whatsoever from Tipperary.
That's very dangerous. You know, in the modern game, the power of these players, and we've been saying it, he left the ground and went flying through the air and could have badly hurt Casey there.
Well, the referee, has he issued any card? I didn't see anything.
He didn't see anything either.
Well, if the referee did see it, it certainly merited a sanction and possibly a red card. Coming in number 23, and that is Mark Keogh. UCC student, Mark, scored a wonder goal, replaces John McGrath, scored a wonder goal in this year's Fitzgibbon Cup final. This is the second goal here, scored calmly and coolly by the excellent Kyle Hayes, who's got a goal and one on what's looking like being a very much a winning day for Limerick, another day of celebration for those here on Shannon's side.
Yeah, and mentioned John Kiley a little bit earlier. Here's the tackle again now. Just watch Ronan Maher, comes off the ground there. And that's straight into the head, and that's... The modern or the new rule this year, a head high tackle like that is a red card, and he's got away with it any card.
I can't believe that the officials haven't seen it. Well, the injured Limerick player, who is Peter Casey, doesn't look the best at all. The doctor there, James Ryan, attending to him, the physio Mark Van Drunt. And another change is about to take place, and a big cheer for Seamus Flanagan, one of the heroes of last year.
Well, Casey scored 1-5, and players can get injured in any match, we know that, but you know, he doesn't deserve to be leaving the field after a tackle like that, after giving an absolutely brilliant display. One, a goal in 5 points, fought so hard to get onto this team, and now leaving the field like that.
It's interesting how John Kiley and the management team made some subtle changes this season. Will O'Donoghue getting more game time. Peter Casey used an awful lot, and it's worked really well in Limerick's favour. They're heading for their third win in 5 matches in this year's championship. They're heading for the semi-finals of the All-Ireland. They will take some beating, the champions from 2018. Cian Lynch, as far as Dowling. Back it goes again to Darragh O'Donovan. Asking quite a bit there of Gillan to try and get to that one. Brendan Maher has done as well as anybody could do, I think, against Gillan. That's driven back here by Tom Morrissey. From 2 points to 3 points now for the 23-year-old from Ahan.
A great score again. You know, great patience there for the Limerick players. Worked the ball around until the shot was on and the right man taking the shot. You saw Dan having a couple of pots earlier. Here's Flanagan. You see that? So you mentioned there, lads have been left off this team and been brought on. And, you know, we saw Brian Cody doing that over the years with Kilkenny as well, making a change or two, keeping lads on their toes, taking them off if they're not playing well. And Kylie has got this great display of him today by doing that.
There's Sean O'Brien. All the way across here as far as Ronan Moore. In it goes. Carried forward here by Mark Keogh. Making sure he was winning that ball with some determination in there is Declan Haddon.
Yeah, you can see the inexperience of some of these lads. Here's a flick in there by Marco. The inexperience of some of these Tipperary lads who are getting the ball and they think they're going to outrun these lads. It's not going to happen. You know, it has to happen a lot quicker. It's just the Limerick lads are just jogging along beside them. They're waiting to take the ball off them. So it's going to be a learning curve for them. But you can see the loss, I think, of Bonner Maher in the half forward. And the whole half forward today collapsed without his leadership and without his power. And Colin Barrett in the fullback line because Brendan Maher has gone out there. Brendan Maher's had a fine game in Aaron Gillan, apart from one from play. And he set up the goal. Mara's done really well, but he's missed out the field, so he's a lot more influence. So, as you said earlier, Tipperary have the starting 15, Limerick have this squad. It's going to be very hard to beat based on today's display.
First defeat since he's been back in the championship. That's going to result in a bit of head-scratching for Liam Sheedy and his management team. A couple of weeks now to prepare for the next game. There'll be five additional minutes. That ball hit in and hit wide as well by Dermot Burns. Doesn't miss too many, got three this afternoon. Hard to imagine, we look at the scoreboard, Michael, that Tipperary, with time almost up, 10 points behind.
Yeah, Gerard, they haven't scored for 15 minutes, and just shows you the complete dominance of Limerick. They've just overpowered them. They've taken all the life out of them, they've sucked the life out of them all over the field, and I think that's the thing that's going to disappoint Liam Sheedy the most. He wouldn't have seen that coming. There's no shame in losing a Munster final, but basically thrown in the towel here, a lot of the players, and no fight in them. And Limerick, you know, they're getting really, is that Declan Hannon going as well here nowadays? But him and Keane Lynch and Hegarty, who were left off the last day, coming back in, they really set the tone from the start, and he's getting a massive, obviously a massive ovation for the crowd.
Yeah, big ovation for Declan Hannon. Barry Nash is on in his stead. So just playing the last 5 minutes, 5.5 minutes then here in Limerick. It's turned out in the end to be a one-sided Munster final, most unexpected. If you go back and read what a lot of people who know their hurling very well were forecasting, they all thought that it would be Tipperary. But Limerick have made it look ridiculously easy. They looked so fresh, so determined. They were intent that they were not going to be beaten at the championship for the third time this year. And this man here has been immense. Kyle Hayes underlines it with a fabulous score. 1-2 for the man who's just 21 years of age from Kildymo Palace Kenry.
That's a brilliant score, brilliant catch. And he just waltzed past the Tipperary defenders. The power the man has is unbelievable.
Flanagan has lost his hurley. Limerick keep it alive. Tipperary aren't even winning their own tuck-outs at this stage. The draggled looking team, which is most unlike the side we saw earlier in the championship. Tom Morrissey just tags on another. He's got a fourth. They are right now making it look ridiculously easy.
That was almost embarrassing.
Tipperary just want to get on the bus and get home.
Exactly. Keane Lynch was able to drop that ball and then pass it on to Tom Morrissey. They've taken off Morrissey, Hegarty, Will O'Donoghue, all Declan Hannon, all players have had outstanding games for
them. And really is it. And there is Barry Nash, and Barry Nash fancies getting a point, and well he might. It's yet another one, 225 to 212. It's a huge score by Limerick here. Beaten 4 points by Tipperary 2 weeks ago, and they've turned it around decisively, emphatically. Seamus Flanagan. taking on the nearest defender to him, and that ball, the challenge came in from Barry Heffernan. Referee eventually blows the whistle in Tipperary's favour.
And, you know, Ger, it's hard to believe there was only 3 points in it. Limerick have scored 1-7 without reply. They've just blown away Tipperary here in the last 10 minutes, and, you know, there was maybe some doubts. I was one of them saying, is this rotation working? Can they reproduce, you know, the level of form of last year? Well, seemed to be going along okay without firing on all cylinders, but today they've, you know, as good as if not better than any display that they gave last.
There will be quite a degree of re-evaluation going on over the next couple of, well, next week, next day or so, as to how good Tipperary are. Can they recover from this immediately? They'll be heading for the quarter-finals, of course, that much we do know. Got a couple of weeks to prepare for that, and they have big battles ahead. Free to Tipp. Back in it comes again towards Seamus Callanan. Turning around here, this time is Mark Keogh. And that one fired over the bar. It's a point by Jason Ford. He's got a sixth. It just about raises a cheer from some of the Tipp fans who are still here. Bitter disappointment for Liam Sheedy. He's prepared this team meticulously. John Kiley has had the edge in things this afternoon, however. Two men who are All-Ireland winners looking for another one. And that last shot has got another score for Tipp. Jerome Cahill gets his first ever championship point. You can't really say it puts a better gloss on the final scoreboard, because they've been absolutely roundly beaten.
I was down here for the league match between these two counties, and, you know, I thought that evening that Tipperary weren't showing their hand. So Limerick did the very same thing to them that evening.
Flanagan, Dowling involved, Mulcahy, great play. Graham Mulcahy gets a second. Shane Dowling was the man with the assist pass at the end. But the subs come in, they look impressive, they want to show what they can do. And they've all got a very, very good attitude. John Kiley obviously stressing the fact that every member of the panel is a vital member of the panel. From one to whatever it is, 30 players. Dowling again, blocked down this time. Back it comes. Niall O'Mara involved, hand pass by Cahill. An opportunity to throw the shoulders here and get maybe a last scoring opportunity, which didn't come for anything there for Robert Byrne. Well, Robert Byrne is one of those young players that the new Tipperary of the future years will be built. There's still an awful lot left, I'm sure, in Tipperary. There's a yellow card, and that's for Barry Nash. Final few seconds then of this Munster final, where Limerick have enjoyed a resounding success. 12 points in front at this stage. All the way down here, as far as Keogh, sniffing on the ground, kept at bay there. Richie English trying to make sure that Tipp don't get any more late scores. That ball runs loose. Out came Mike Casey. On it goes, the referee blows the whistle. Limerick celebrates. They are Munster champions once again. Munster champions for the first time in 6 years. And for John Kiley and the management team, it's a day to remember, a day to savour. The All-Ireland champions then became the league champions. And now, here in late June, they are the Munster champions as well, Michael.
Yes, Gerard. It's a huge day for an awful lot of those Limerick players. I mentioned before the game, they hadn't won Munster medals, and a Munster medal means an awful lot. You know, the Munster championship at the moment, so competitive, so many good teams, but an absolutely brilliant display. 226, 220 from play. Their forwards were just immense. You know, they got scores from everywhere. Hegarty 3, Morrissey 4 from play, Peter Casey 1-5, Hayes 1-2, Mulcahy 2. Gallan was probably their quietest forward. So that says it all. Brendan Maher doing a good job on him. But overall, an absolutely brilliant display from their forwards, not just from scoring, but their tackling, and I think their tackling, their forwards, the physicality from midfield up to number 15 set the tone for this game, and They allowed Tipperary to get no clean possession, get no rhythm into the game, and they left them in it for a long time, but eventually they punished them and put them away very easily at the end.
Tipp may have been the team of the championship so far, certainly in Munster, but it's Limerick who end the season as Munster champions. They've had 12 points to spare over Tipperary this afternoon, and Noel McGrath there and Dan McCormack, they have lots and lots of work to do. They haven't got too much time in which to do it, to try and come back into the championship again. But Limerick march on. The All-Ireland champions were absolutely brilliant this afternoon. They had so many extra goal chances as well, you know. We saw some fabulous saves by Brian Hogan. It could have been a cricket score.
Well, they could have scored another three goals. I know Seamus Callan had a chance for Tipp, but that was probably crucial. It just shows you the way hurling can go, would have brought it back to three. But really, you know, it was all about Limerick today. And hurling is like that. It's a funny game. Tipperary coming down here today. I thought there might be a couple of points in one way or the other, but Limerick firmly back on track. They're going to be favourites for the All-Ireland again now after this.